Check.
I can see by the dawn, words have lost their meaning, but we're carrying on. And I feel you so strong. Anytime with you is like I'm doing no wrong, and we're moving like we need it. Waves are crashing in, and we can barely perceive it, baby. When you move,
I need move.
You make me feel like I got something to prove.
I got something to prove.
I wanna change your mind. I wanna make you mine. I wanna figure it out.
What?
I wanna show you how. I wanna know what it means, what you're all about. Take your time. I wanna
We're back.
Change your mind. I wanna make you mine. I wanna figure it out.
Shift face.
Shift face.
I know what it means to be on your side. Sunshine on my baby, out on the floor.
Summertime.
Sometimes love shines like never before.
What? Slow down.
There's a word.
Boom.
For your kiss. Any definition is a failed attempt. And the way of your word.
This is a great tune.
Right?
Haunt me in my dreams.
Super chill. Perfect summer song.
Oh, yeah.
Some might even refer to it as a dopamine. Baby. What's happening, Sam?
What is up?
What is
Where
up?
Where did you find that song? I've never heard that before.
Random Google Play Music's playlist.
Cool.
Love these playlists. They're really, really cool. They actually introduced me to a lot of new songs that I would never fucking find on my own.
Totally. I've been listening to so many podcasts lately. I haven't listened to a lot of music, but just the fact that you found this song makes me want to get
discover
back
more music.
Yeah, definitely.
Honestly, it's funny enough, it's the opposite with me. I've actually stopped listening to a lot of podcasts. I've been just listening to music.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
Yeah, and you know, I kind of mentioned this to you earlier. I want to incorporate more music into my life.
Right, yeah.
I actually think it's, well, I know that it is, it really affects your mood.
Definitely.
You can, you know, if you wake up in the morning, like I've tried this a couple times now, you wake up in the morning, the first thing you do is you listen to music. You listen to something upbeat, something positive, something good. And it kind of just sets you for the rest of the day, you know? It's it's like,
for
it
sure.
Just puts you in this good mood and you just keep it going and you just listen to music as you go. And
yeah, if I get up and I listen to music, say when I'm like getting ready or tidying up the apartment or something, then I will listen to music throughout the day. But if I get up and I put a podcast on, or if I get up and don't listen to anything, then I really won't.
Right. Fair enough. And
seek it out. You know
that,
what I mean?
That was me. I used to listen to podcasts all the time. And then, you know what? I'm not going to lie. I'm going to give credit where credit is due. I got this
to
idea.
Me?
No.
Oh, damn it.
I got this idea from Gianluca Vacchi, as a lot of people out there might know. And if you don't know, just Google him. Or Instagram I'm sorry. Just this rich Italian fucking older dude. Like stereotypical rich Italian tan dude living it up. And he's constantly like all his posts, it's him and music and just like
dancing
and like even working out with music or even just like he's driving and he's just like what's music. And it's like, man, that's cool. Like I don't, every time I watch one of his stories, it puts me in a good mood. And then I realized that, hey, music has a lot to do with it. So why not do that for myself? And I have recently just started doing that, and it's great. I used to listen to a lot of music. And then,
I feel like
I don't know what
happened. You know, you go through phases.
Totally. That's right. You go through phases.
So where have we been?
Oh my God.
It's been a long time.
Super sorry,
since
listeners.
We have recorded, which is crazy and sad, but.
Crazy and sad.
We're back at it again.
Just gotten away. And
it's been a busy, busy, busy summer.
Yeah.
And it's not getting less busy.
No, it's not getting less busy
Which
at all.
Is
Especially
great.
The past
like,
couple
it's,
weeks. Was
it's
super
been amazing.
Busy.
It's been probably one of the best summers of my life so far.
It's a great summer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The weather's been fucking perfect in Vancouver.
Weather in Vancouver has been fantastic.
Yeah.
Not even a single drop of rain. It's just been beautiful. Oh, we got a couple of...
Yeah, but nothing...
Nothing major.
Nothing like most places.
No.
And it's been, I would say, on average, a consistent 25 degrees and sunny.
Oh, yeah.
Every day, which is like, what more could you ask for?
Yeah, it's been fantastic.
Yeah.
So we've been busy doing that and fucking living it up. And your family visited last week.
Yeah, they, yeah, so they just left Vancouver on mm-hmm. Saturday. Today is Tuesday.
Tuesday.
So it's very recent that they were here. And we spent the week with them and, you know, hung out in Vancouver for a bit. We went to Harrison for two mm-hmm. nights, all six of
us. Harrison Hot Springs.
And we stayed in a house all together, which was fun.
Oh, I got some bad news for you. I'll tell you later on this fucking later.
Okay. that's very ominous.
Yeah, I'm just saying. I just remembered. I totally forgot to tell you about this.
All right. You don't want to tell me on the podcast?
No, I'll tell you on the podcast, but I'm not going to tell you right away.
Oh, all
right. I'll let you marinate on that one for a little bit.
But yeah, so that was fun. I mean, I only get to see my family about once every... So far, it's been once every like 10 months since I've moved here.
Right.
So it was really a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun. I had a blast. I had a really good time.
Fucking partying.
Yeah, my body is thanking me right now for not partying as hard and taking it easy. Because holy fucking shit balls.
We partied pretty much every night.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
Like drinking and fucking partying and straight West Coasting basically, right?
Mm-hmm. Especially in Harrison. God, we went hard in Harrison.
Yeah, we went hard
in Harrison. Just staying at the house, just the six of us. Fucking drinking games, flip cup, kings.
You name it. Ugh. We did it all.
Yeah.
We did it all. Heroin, math.
Okay, okay, okay. But it was fun. It was, yeah.
No, I had a good time. Yeah, I had a really, really good time. Okay, you know what? I'm not even fucking going to beat around the bush, as they say. I'm going to tell you the bad news.
Tell me.
So a friend of mine, coworker, named Julia, she also went to Harrison Hot Springs. She went basically oh, she no. we left.
I know calm exactly. down. I know exactly calm what down. It's gonna be.
No, you don't yeah, know what it's gonna be. No, you don't. Well, you kinda do. Mm-hmm. So we left on Thursday and she arrived on Friday and she spent the weekend there. So I asked her, I'm like, hey, so did you go to the hot springs? Because here's the fucked up part about Harrison Hot Springs is apparently if you don't stay at the fucking resort, then you can't enjoy the hot springs. Unless
also,
you want
apparently you can't enjoy the hot springs because they're too hot. So what they do at the resort is they use the water from the hot springs to fill these pools.
Yeah.
But the pools are cooled down so that you can go in them and you can experience the mineral-rich water from the hot springs. But it's not like, for instance, we went to the Hot Springs Cove near Tofino.
Yeah.
And that was like legit natural
hot
springs.
That was a natural hot spring. I was in the middle of rocks.
Yeah. And anyway, so apparently it's not like that.
So so the only other option we had was basically go to the public fucking pool there, like a bunch of fucking refugees. Just
okay. Take
just saying. It's like what, like 10 bucks to get in and it's just you go in there. Like,
and
we
just
looked around.
Pool.
It's just like a sad fucking
like a
bunch
pool.
Of like old people in a rec center. No, thank you. I didn't come on vacation to go to a rec center. Yeah. Anyway. I was talking to Julia and I told her, I was like, yeah, how crazy is that? Isn't that nuts? She's like, yeah, it's crazy. But you know what we did? I'm like, what did you do? She's like, nothing. Her and her boyfriend / significant other, I don't really know what their status is, but they, she's like, oh no, you just have to go and do the spa and you get access to the whole thing for the whole day.
That's what I fucking thought.
And I was like,
the
spa, what do you mean? She's
like,
so
must be able to just pay for it.
Right. And then I was like, how much is the spa? And she's like, oh no, it wasn't like really a spa. We just went and got pedicures for $20 and we got access to the whole fucking day.
Oh my God.
And I was like, oh my God, because I know
were
Sam,
they cool? Did you say they were cool or was
she
it
said
just
they were awesome?
Oh man.
And I was like, damn, that sucks because Sam, her sister and her mom wanted to actually come back to Vancouver and go get a pedicure done.
That's so frustrating.
And you could have done that in Harrison.
I kept asking everyone, I was like, guys, are you sure we can't just pay for it? Like there gotta be
asking?
Some way. The people who went into the hotel to ask, which were Julia and
Julia being your sister, not
the
Julia that
not,
I'm talking
not
about.
Not to confuse. But Julia and...
My boyfriend, Tarek.
Tarek, I think.
Do you think that's her boyfriend's name?
No,
or you think
I mean, it was either Julia and Tarek or Julia and my dad or
Julia
and my mom.
Anyway. Well, next time, skip the middleman and just do it yourself and we'll figure it out.
Yes, yeah.
But
however, we didn't do the hot springs thing in Harrison, but we had a, like... I thought, you know, it was a great time. We hung out at the beach, played beach volleyball. We went swimming in the lake.
Swimming. Almost died. Yeah. Well, your sister almost died.
Right.
That was optimistic.
You almost had to save her.
Yeah, we there was this tiny little lagoon that we had to swim across. And it's so weird. And, well, it's not weird. I already knew this. Me being super, like, into fucking survival stuff and outdoors and blah, 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 blah. One of the things they always tell you if you're in the middle of a desert somewhere or you're in the middle of the ocean, if you see a, let's say, an end goal, like, for instance, somewhere you want to swim to or you want to canoe to, take that distance. It looks like it's, let's say, 2 kilometers,
mm-hmm.
but, like, double it. Or something like that.
Yeah.
It's because your eyes play a trick on you. It's
well, also,
especially out there.
Does it have anything to do with the fact that water isn't stagnant? Like it
moves, yeah. Oh, yeah. Right? Absolutely. Absolutely. And I didn't do that. And I just jumped in the water with your sister and we just both swam.
But
and
also, the rest of us never thought anything of it. Like, you guys were like, we're going to swim across. And we're like, okay, cool. Have fun.
Yeah.
Like, none of us were like, I don't know. That might be too far.
Yeah. And it was like,
because it doesn't look very far, but when I was watching you guys, like you were swimming pretty fast.
Yeah, I know.
And I was like, they're like still got a ways to go.
Yeah. And that was it. That was the second mistake that I made that day was I sprinted. I just jumped in water and I booked it. And maybe what, like a quarter away,
got
I was just
tired.
Like, I was gassed. I was like,
because you guys were trying to race at first.
Yeah, we were trying to race at first. And I was gassed and I was like, fuck, fuck, fuck. This is like, and easy way to tell is basically look what is ahead of you, how far you got to go, and then look back how far you've gone.
Right.
That kind of gives you
gauge
a distance.
It, gauge it. Yeah.
And yeah, it was bad. So, and another thing is not a lot of people like do this, but it's not that difficult. It's quite simple is you go on your back and you catch your breath.
That's what Julia did.
Yeah, that's what I did too. You just go on your back and you kind of like slowly swim.
Because you can float.
You can float. Back. Yeah, you can float on your back and then you just basically catch your breath.
Yeah.
And then you go again. Yeah. And then we kept going. And then your sister's like, I don't know if I could do this. We're like in the middle of fucking like this lagoon.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, she's saying this now. Like, there's no way, like, we can't even scream. Like, no one's going to hear us.
We could have heard you if you screamed.
Oh, I don't know. I don't know if I could have screamed. I could have screamed.
Mm.
It was weird. Anyway, so I was like, no, you're fine. You're fine. You can do this. And then I went to my second thought was that, okay, can I carry her with me to the other end? And I was confident enough that I could. It will just take a long time for me to do it.
That would have been insane.
I know. That would have been insane. But, or at least I could have carried her to a point that she catches her breath, regains some of her strength, and then she can swim the rest. But anyway, we fucking made it, and we're here now.
Crazy kids.
Right?
That same time when you guys were swimming across, me, my dad, and Tarek were in the same body of water, but we were just kind of waiting in our
I'm sorry. I think you were looking for something.
That's what I'm getting to.
Oh, okay.
So we're standing there, like, well, Tarek's kind of swimming a little bit. And my dad and I are standing side by side, just chatting. And we're like, you know, in the water to our knees. And all of a sudden, my dad's like, all right, I'm going in. And he just dives in. My dad wears glasses. He comes back out and he's like walking back towards me. Big smile on his face, like, had a great time diving in the water. And I'm like, Dad, where's your glasses? He's like, what? I'm like, where's your glasses?
Oh,
he's like,
God.
I gave them to you before I went in. I was like, no, absolutely not. He's like, yes, I handed them to you. I was like, absolutely not. Like, I am a sane mind right now, and there's no way that happened. I watched you dive in with your glasses on. So, and then we had to spend, what, like, half an hour looking
something
for them?
Something like that.
And then finally, Tarek found them tangled in
Tarek
the
savior.
Which, I mean, thank goodness, because he didn't have a backup pair or anything. And he's, like, legit blind.
Yeah.
So that would have been really
bad. That would have been bad.
Yeah.
But anyway, it was all good. It was all good. I played volleyball. I didn't think I could fucking play volleyball because the last time I played volleyball, I sucked balls.
Yeah, you were great. You were just as good as the rest of us.
I did okay.
None of us were amazing.
I think I did okay.
Yeah.
So that's another thing. It's like, okay, so past couple of weeks, 2 weeks, I've realized two things, that I can actually play two different sports fairly okay and get away with it. One being fucking volleyball. Second being tennis. We just got into tennis. We live right by the fucking basketball courts, tennis courts. So we went and played tennis. And I truly thought yesterday and today, fucking fantastic. So much fun. And I was like telling someone, I was like, we got to do this fucking every day.
Yeah, it's literally at our doorstep.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's free.
It's free.
And it's a great workout. And it's you get to hang out in the sun.
Oh, my God. Yeah, it's amazing. And
it's the best.
And honestly, I can't.
It is hard, though. Like, I will say that, like,
it's a hard sport.
We're okay at it, like, enough to, like.
I'm not shooting balls all over the fucking place.
Right.
I'm okay at it.
But it is tough. Like, my arm is kind of sore and tired.
Makes you wonder what, like, fucking Serena and Venus and all those people go through and how much strength they actually have.
Yeah, in their arm? Like,
yeah, they have a lot. Like, I'm
not
pretty
even their
sure.
Arm, but, I mean, have you seen their legs?
Oh, yeah.
Like, tree trunks.
I'm pretty sure Serena can knock me out if she
wanted
to.
Absolutely. She could do, she could ruin you.
Okay, Sam.
She could ruin most people on the planet. Me. Definitely.
Sure.
Definitely.
Maybe she can ruin Conor McGregor. Fight coming up. August 26th. The money fight.
So like a month from tomorrow.
Oh my God. I'm like fucking excited. I'm so goddamn excited. Oh, it's going to be so good. It's going to be so good. Did you see the jersey he was wearing? He's wearing a basketball jersey.
Yeah, you told me about it.
Yeah, Conor McGregor was wearing a basketball jersey, and they're like, "What the fuck are you wearing a basketball jersey?" Turns out it was the jersey of this player who banged Mayweather's wife. How fucking awesome is that? That's so fucking funny. Like getting deep into like fucking with some guy's head.
Yeah, he's insane. He doesn't give a fuck. Like he just wants to psychologically destroy his opponents.
Does. Yeah,
I was listening to
it's funny because I feel like when they do it, the opponent does it to him, he gets rattled.
Oh yeah,
he gets rattled.
Yeah,
happened with Nate Diaz. They went to the face off for the weigh in, and Nate Diaz like fucking threw him a fake punch, and he flinched, and that fucked with him. Everyone was talking about how badly that fucked with him. Yeah, it's crazy.
Should we crack this beer?
Oh yeah, first things first.
More like
we haven't been doing this for so long. 13th. That like we're slipping, Sam. We're slipping. We're not doing what we're supposed to be doing.
We always slip on this part of the podcast, to be honest.
I guess.
All right, hear that.
Crack that baby open. What are we drinking? What is it?
This is a Category 12 Brewing dry hopped sour beer.
Where's Category 12 Brewing from?
Category 12 Brewing.
I know where it is.
From. It's from here. It's from Victoria.
Victoria, BC, capital BC. It's Victoria.
That's right. That's where the Parliament is.
That's where the Parliament is.
Such a beautiful city. I wish we could make time to go back this summer, but unfortunately, I don't think we can. We just really have so much going on.
We have so much fucking going on.
What do we have coming up?
We're going to Tofino, man.
That's right. In
greatest place on the fucking planet.
Can't wait.
No, I don't know if I say greatest place on the planet. I haven't been to Hawaii yet.
It's a cloudy beer.
It is a cloud beer.
Greatest place in Canada, which also
greatest place in Canada, is, hands fucking down.
And Canada is, greatest place on the planet, so.
Canada is the greatest place on the planet, so. Yeah, I guess maybe it's the greatest place on the planet.
Kelly,
next best thing would be, like, Mars.
Yeah, Kelly Ripa was in
Mars.
BC.
Mars.
Because her husband was shooting something, and then they went to Tofino. Mm-hmm. And I don't know if anybody watches Kelly Ripa's show, but.
Watch it. Like a diehard of fan.
Course. But she went on her show after her vacation and just raved about Tofino for like the first 15 minutes of the show. Oh, no cheers or anything? You're just going to like...
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I just fucking drank it. Cheers.
So cloudy.
That's all right. Not bad for a sour. It's all right. It's good.
I like it.
It's not my favorite sour.
It's not super sour, but it's what I would expect from a dry hopped sour.
Fair enough.
I like it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
we're going to Tofino. We're going to this music festival called Otolith.
Otolith.
Every time I say it, I feel like I'm saying it wrong.
Otolith? Otolith? That's a weird name.
It doesn't sound natural.
Who came up with that? What does it mean?
I don't know. Also, I saw today, or maybe yesterday, that this is only the fifth one.
Oh, really?
It started in 2013.
Hmm.
Yeah. So we're going to that music festival, which is actually in Ucluelet, which is a neighboring town of Tofino. And that's for our first three nights.
Mm-hmm.
And then we got an Airbnb in Tofino, like right in the town. By the way, I looked on the map where our Airbnb is, mm-hmm. and it's literally right in the center of town. Like it's right
Sweet.
Beside.
I love it.
Oh, fuck. I can't remember, but like.
Whatever. Hey, let's. Speaking of that, I was just going to say is that we're. Hopefully a landlord is not listening to this, but we're thinking about Airbnb-ing our place out while we go away.
We are.
It's a little hush-hush. So all you listeners out there, keep your fucking mouth shut. I'm coming after you with a baseball bat. Just kidding. Yeah, I mean,
we have an awesome apartment right Amazing by Stanley apartment. Park. And we're going to be out of town anyway. So we figure, why not try to make some money, which is money that we're going to be spending on our vacation anyway.
And we got this idea from the Airbnbs that your parent and your sister used while they were here because
when we helped my parents check into their Airbnb when they were here, which was in the same neighborhood that we are in, mm-hmm. West End, right around Robson and Denman. And I booked my parents' Airbnb through my account because obviously they couldn't, you know, do it on their own.
Old people. They're not even that old.
And anyway, so the guy messaged me on the day about check-in and stuff like that. And then he said, P.S., if anyone asks you who you are or what you're doing in the building, don't tell them about Airbnb. Just say that you're staying with me and that you're friends of mine. So because Airbnb is not allowed, basically.
Right. And that gave
Unless
us a
you,
fucking
you
idea.
Own your place. Then you can do whatever you want.
But. That was like a light bulb went on, mm-hmm. and I went off in our head. We're like, oh, shit,
and
son.
You know, I've heard about other people that I've known through work and stuff. I've heard of them doing Airbnb for their apartments, even though they're not allowed. So I've known that obviously people do it, even though they're not supposed to, but it just seems now, I don't know, more possible since I know how widespread it is.
Here's the thing. What's the worst that could fucking happen? We can either make a lot of money or we can get a fucking warning from our landlord. Because they can't just evict you for that. They give you a warning, you do it again, then you get evicted.
That's right.
We'll get a warning. Who gives a fuck? I already hit the fucking asshole anyway. He gave me shit. We were trying to put fucking hammocks up on the in the balcony. I drilled once. Sure, it was loud. But it only took
in the middle
a minute
of the day.
Middle of the day.
And it took what? Probably 10 minutes total.
Drilling time? No,
but from when you started to when it was over.
Sure. And anyway, he came up and he's just this fucking old fart. Anyway, I put it up. And then the second one, we already spent over $100 on this hammock. So I'm like, I'm not letting this fucker go. I got to install this bad boy. So what I did is that the next day, or no, 2 days after, I'm trying to gauge it, see where he's at. If he leaves the apartment building, then I can drill while he's away or something. So I'm downstairs in the lobby walking around, kind of hanging out. I took the recycling out, blah, blah, blah. Just kind of hanging out in the lobby, just see what he's doing. Then I come down the elevator. I was about to get on the elevator, hit the fucking button, elevator opens. About to get in there, and then he comes behind me, and it's like, "Oh no, Tony! Hey, listen, can I take this one? Because I'm gonna go inside it and vacuum."
Right.
And to me, it was like, "Ding, ding, 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 ding."
Perfect time.
Perfect time. He's going into this fucking prison cell of an elevator and vacuum, mind you.
Yeah.
So I ran up the fucking stairs, right? And I was like, I grabbed the drill, put the fucking drill bit in, went into the fucking roof in the ceiling, and drilled, 30 seconds tops, donezo. And then I go outside, I can still hear the vacuum cleaner.
Mm-hmm.
He had no fucking clue what I did.
Right.
Put the hammock, install the hammock, put the fucking screws in, everything. It's done. Donezo, no problem whatsoever. A couple days after, I see him. He says, hey. I was like, hey.
No, you're missing it. So when you did the when he was vacuuming in the elevator, you did it, and then you thought it was done, but it didn't quite go all the way in. So you needed to do a little bit more drilling. So
no, that was it, man. I did it right there.
No. Because remember, it was when they were doing outside
yard work. You're right. Sorry, you're right. I did quite a bit. And then it was just one little tiny bit left. One little tiny bit. I'm talking fucking 10 to 20 seconds of drilling.
It was definitely more than that.
No, it wasn't.
It was minutes.
Minutes?
I was here and I listened to the drilling. It was definitely at least 2 minutes.
I don't know. Whatever the fuck. Anyway, so there was someone outside fucking trimming the hedges or whatever, fucking mowing the lawn or something. It was super fucking loud. And then Sam tells me, Tony, this is our chance. Drill away because no one would fucking hear it. And so I fucking booked it. I drilled the rest of it in. And I'm telling you, no one could have fucking heard it. It was done. And we installed the hammock. Hammock was done. Everyone's happy. And I see the manager the next day. I say, hey, to him. Nothing. He says, hey. Then I come up. I'm like, oh, shit, I got to do laundry. So I take my laundry downstairs. We got our laundries in the basement. Do my laundry. I'm coming back up. He sees me. He kind of gives me a look. And then I'm about to get it. And then he fucking yells at me. You know you're driving that lady underneath you insane. I'm like, I'm sorry, what? And it's like, you're driving her insane. He's like yelling at me and shit. I'm like, what are you talking about? It's like, yeah, you've been drilling twice after I gave you that warning. And obviously, I'm not going to fucking just be like budge and be like, oh, yeah, I'm so sorry. I'm like, what are you talking about? I wasn't drilling. And it's like, right. No, you were. And I was like, well, no, it wasn't. It's like, you drilled twice. And he's like kind of getting my face, fucking eyeballing me and shit, yelling at me. That's the thing. That was it for me. That crossed the fucking line. Listen, have a conversation with me and I'll tell you the fucking truth and I'll be cool about it. Whatever, right? And plus, it's fucking done. It was middle of the day. It's not a big deal. Right. But you coming up to me, like eyeballing me, fucking screaming at me, yelling at me. Anyway, so what happened is that then I like kind of bullshit. I was like, well, here's the thing. The second time that you're fucking speaking of, I was actually cleaning my drill. I was fixing it. I had to turn it on and it made a lot of noise. Sorry. Fuck, it was middle of the fucking day. I was drilling any holes. I was just fixing something.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, yeah. And the third, and this is what he told me. And the third time, you thought you could hide it by like doing it while the guy was outside, like trimming the fucking hedges and, you know, mowing the lawn. And then I kind of looked at him and I was like, you're welcome. Like, fuck. I went out of my way to make sure that it's at a noisy fucking time that doesn't bother anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, then he's like, so you're just going to stop now? This is it. This is the last of it. I was like, yeah, it's the last of it. It's done. Okay. Anyway, before I used to be like, hey, Ken, how are you? Every time I saw him. Now, like literally, I say maybe a hey. If it's kind of awkward, it's just him and I. I say, hey. And he looks at me and say, hey. Because, you know, I only say this because when we were in Ottawa, we had a landlord, Andre, was his name.
That's right.
Sweetest fucking man on the planet. Yeah. And every time anything fucking happened, whatever, he would come up or like he would see me. He would say something. He's like, hey, I heard this. Do you need any hand with it? Like literally, what's going on? What are you trying to do?
Yeah.
And I'm like, hey, I'm trying to do this, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay. You know, he would pretty much be like, do it at this time or like, I'll help you out with it.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Yeah, amazing.
He was the best for sure.
And plus versus this guy, like fuck him. Anyway, fuck, sorry, I didn't mean to go all fucking
let's move on.
This guy's been fucking bugging me for a while now and I had to kind of
blow off some steam,
as they say. So what's going on with you, Sam? What's new?
You know, not a whole lot other than just like enjoying the summertime, taking these mini vacations here and there.
How's work?
Really excited for Tofino. Work is slow as balls. It's slow. Not gonna lie.
Kind of weird, eh?
Yeah. So I worked tonight. You were off tonight.
I was.
I finished early because it was so slow. I had a table of like two guys, and so we have features, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the guy apparently called ahead and was like, I need you to have risotto. We don't have risotto.
So, is that what he said? Yeah, she said, I need you to have risotto.
Yeah. So they made a risotto feature.
Fucking people.
Anyway, so they were just like very particular and whatever. They were fine, but they were kind of particular and like a little, I don't say strange, but just like, I don't know, particular.
Mm-hmm.
And when they were paying, the one guy looked at me and was like, do you remember your first boyfriend's name?
What the fuck?
I was like, yeah. He's like, what is it?
What is it, Sam?
Jason when I was in.
Jason. I hate every Jason's ever lived.
I was in grade one.
Grade one.
Slut. Obviously not a real boyfriend, but you're like, oh, it's my boyfriend. Anyway. And he was like, okay. He's like, I can't remember anything. He's like, but you're like 22, so like you can remember anything. That's fine. And
you must have loved that comment.
Well, I mean, he's an old man, so like 22, 28, like what's the difference?
29.
What?
No, nothing.
What did you just say?
nothing.
What did you just say?
I just said, you mean 29, right?
I do not. On this day, July 25th, 2017, I am
Sam's birthday years is old. On July 29th. She's going to turn 29, so it's going to be her champagne birthday.
Turning 29 on the 29th.
29th or the 29th.
That's right. Champagne birthday.
Champagne birthday. It's going to be a good one.
Anywho.
I think.
So, yeah, that was...
Sorry.
That was work tonight. That was the only story I have to tell because it was so fucking slow.
That was your work tonight.
However, right? I have another little funny thing.
Please tell.
Two gentlemen, and one of the gentlemen is a regular, mm-hmm. and he was like, sat down, and he's very like, he knows what he wants. So like, I go over right away. I'm like, what would you like? And he says, I'd like a burger medium rare with side of fries. Sorry, not medium rare, rare. Absolutely no problem.
Right.
And the other guy talks to me about, like, he wants some whatever, this dish, and then he wants some wine, blah, blah, blah. So then I finish taking the order, and I'm like, absolutely, gentlemen, like, I'll get that on the way for you. And I start to walk away, and I'm, like, walking away, and the first guy is like, wait, make it a chicken burger. I'm like, okay, no problem. So I go, and I bring it in, chicken burger with fries.
Chicken burger rare.
No, of course not. That's disgusting.
Salmonella.
So chicken burger with fries. And then at least, like, I would say 6 minutes later, I'm back at the table delivering some wine to the other gentleman. And the first guy is like, you know what? I'll have a rare burger.
Oh, my God.
I'm like, okay.
Dude, your burger's on the fucking grill already.
Right? I'm like, yeah, okay, absolutely.
We're talking medium.
No problem. And, No. So what do you mean you're talking medium? He changed it from a chicken burger to a rare burger.
Oh,
so it's a completely different thing.
Never mind. I thought he had...
I'm like, okay, I have to run to the kitchen right away to like get them to cancel the chicken burger, which they're already making.
Right.
And tell them that they want a rare burger to have with the other guys.
How do you guys make your chicken burger?
I don't know.
It's not like a... Is it like chicken breast?
I think it's chicken breast.
And then you bread it and make it into a patty?
No. It's just... Literally just
a grilled chicken sandwich, basically.
Basically. It's just a burger, but sub the burger patty for a grilled chicken breast.
All right.
Anyway, so I'm like, as soon as he says that, I'm like, okay, no problem. And then I start to like run to the kitchen. But then the other guy starts asking me a million questions about like the wine selection. And I'm like, yeah, absolutely. And he's like, okay, just, he's like, don't go anywhere. I just have to, and I'm like, fuck my life.
Your burger's turning into well done.
Right? Well, no, it's not turning into well done. It's a different burger, remember?
Your chicken's turned into a blackened chicken.
Right, but he's not even having the chicken.
And so I got to change that to a rare burger. Yeah. I know. Hey, I'm following you, man.
So anyway, so then finally I get to the kitchen, and thankfully, like, he's a regular who's very picky. So when I tell the kitchen, hey, it's this guy.
The kitchen was aware.
And he just... Like, the chef I worked with tonight, he was just like, oh, shit, okay. And then he just canceled it and got on the way. So they weren't mad at me, but I was like,
dude. Fucking people,
do you
right?
not understand the fact that this is already cooked for you? Like,
no, they don't. They think it's almost like a vending machine. They just, you know, they just make, like, order and it'll come out. But they can kind of stop it at some point and something else will come out. Well, that's people for you, you know? Yeah.
People.
What can I tell you? So, you know, it's been a fucking while since we recorded an episode. I would say, 3 weeks?
At least. Yeah.
So I feel like we're a little rusty at the moment. That's why I actually think, and you know what, Sam, what do you think? I just think we should make this one a little bit shorter than usual.
Yeah, sure. I mean,
so we get back into it, you know, and then we're going to be popping out those 1 hour fucking sessions and you guys are going to all fucking enjoy it. And you're like, oh my God, Chef Face is giving me back life. That's what most people say.
I think that's what people feel.
No, that's what they say.
And feel. Yeah.
Cool. Anyway, thanks for fucking tuning in, folks.
And don't forget to follow us on Instagram at Chef Face Pod. We are on Facebook as well, Twitter, and you can subscribe to our podcast on all podcast platforms.
Yeah.
And give us a rating.
Give us a rating. Your best bet is like literally go on our fucking Instagram account, take any of the pictures we put up. It's called @shiftfacedpod and leave a comment. You can be like, Tony, Sam, you suck. Tony, Sam, you're awesome. Say whatever the fuck you want. Just leave us a comment. And because that's where we're most active. It's kind of weird. A podcast, a fucking audio-based media platform, being more active on a picture-based media platform.
Picture and video.
Picture and video. Like, but that's weird. What we like doing. That's what we enjoy. So, you know, come get a bit of a shit face. I don't know what was going with that. Just hit us up.
Vibe.
Hit us up on fucking Instagram. What do we got listening? What are we closing this out with?
We are closing this out with the Passion Passenger.
Passion?
Passion.
Passenger by an old school fucking punk guy named Iggy Pop. Boom.
Bright and hollow sky. It is a city asleep.